Knockout handles models a little bit differently. Instead of storing our data in a plain old object or as a simple value, we use a special kind of knockout object to keep track of our data. That's called an observable. If you open up the Knockout homepage and pull up the terminal, you can actually run Knockout code. Now, before we actually get into how observables work, I want to dispel any magic. Observables are not magical objects. These are just objects with special functions on them. Let's go ahead and make an observable in the console here and run console.dir on it. I've made var foo equals ko.observable. I'm giving it a default value of 0. And if I run console.dir on foo, we will see all of the stuff that's inside of it. As you can see, foo is a function, so we can run it. And there's also all kinds of stuff on it. Now, we don't know what any of these functions do yet, but that's what the documentation is for. The point is, there's no actual magic going on. This is just JavaScript. Now, I'm not going to cover everything about observables, but I will cover the basics of them for you. If you want more detail, take a look at the Knockout documentation. Let's make an observable to keep track of our favorite number. When we make an observable with Knockout, we pass in the initial value. If we want to get the value, we just run it, favNum, with no argument inside. It returns 42. So rather than saying var num equals 42, and then just getting the value by typing num, I've created a ko.observable, and to get the value, I need to run it as a function with no arguments. Now, why is it that we need to run this function rather than just get the value directly? Well, as it turns out, there isn't currently a great cross-browser way to run some code when a value updates normally. So let's say that var num equals 42 is being shown somewhere in the view. If I change num to 43, the view has no way of knowing that that has changed. All we did is change a value. We didn't actually run any code. The way Knockout gets around this is by making it so you have to run a function in order to change any values. So if I want to change my favNum to 43, all I do is run favNum, and instead of passing in nothing, I'll pass in 43. When I do that, now favNum is 43. Now the point is, I've run code when I ran this. FaveNum is a function. When FaveNum gets run and something gets passed in, it changes the value that's stored inside the model somewhere, and it runs some special code, which notifies anyone who is using FaveNum, whether that's another model or the view. See, observers notify the view model when the model changes. And what's more, Knockout runs some extra code that figures out what parts of the view need to be updated when the view model has been notified. It's actually really, really cool. Back before, we had to call view.render anytime something would change. But Knockout is smart enough to know that when these things change here, certain other things need to be notified, and then eventually something needs to get re-rendered. So if you use normal values here, Knockout won't be keeping track of them for you. If you use observables, Knockout will keep track of them for you, and it'll intelligently manage any views that need to get changed or other models that depend on our data that just changed.